Hey guys, welcome back to the very exciting tutorial of creating process, and in today's we're making this another very catchy logo design. And if you look at this logo, it has got a circle with certain thickness, and here we have got a various shades of gradient color which has been applied on a various small pieces. So to design this logo, we'll first create out this circle with the help of ellipse tool and with the help of stroke thickness and with the help of now divide object below option, we'll be creating this unique design. So let's begin the tutorial. So to design this, we'll first select the ellipse tool and left click your mouse button, and here keep the width and height around 200, make sure it's locked and click OK. So you got a nice circle of 200 points. Now after that, we'll click here. You can see there is a two arrow, just click on it and the object will be filled, the stroke will be filled up with certain color. And after that, we'll click here and with the shift press just scroll up, and you can increase it at a random speed. And after that, just over here fill it up with 36 points and make sure it's 36 points. For our logo, we are taking around 36 points. Now next thing is we'll be doing some stuff here. So we'll be just convert this into object form. So to go to object, path and outline stroke, and this it is now filled object. Now after that, we'll use the ellipse tool, and from the center here just click, and with the shift and alt press just click and drag, and you create a nice circle and fill it up with stroke color black. After that, we'll create one more from the center in the same way with the shift and alt pressed. From here center just click and drag, and you create a nice circle like this and fill it up with like that. Now after that, select this inner piece and just with a shift press from here click and just drag, and you can see here it has extended and here the point is stationary. We need that point to be there. Now after that, we'll just select this and from here just click the circle and with a shift press just drag it down, and it will be dragged down in a straight order. And after that, just place it in the center. Now the next thing is, we'll just select this, go to object, path, divide object below, and this will divide this into separate pieces. In the same way, select this circle, go to object, path, divide this below, and here we got three shades of color, three shapes in this. Now the next thing is, we'll just rotate this, and before that we'll just draw two more circles. So with the help of circle, just draw one circle around like this, around maybe 120. Let's check it out the size. Okay, that's fine. Now after that, we'll fill this up with stroke color and make it black, and now place this around here in the center like that, and just duplicate this with the alt press, just click, and with the shift press just click and drag, on the shift press just drag it down in a straight. And after that, just scale this up a little bit and make sure this point is aligned to this. So we'll just click and drag it down with the shift press and make sure around here like that. And after that, with a shift press from this corner, just drag it up like this. So you can see we got that. Now next thing is, we'll select everything and deselect these two circles, and with a shift press just rotate it to one angle like this. That's around 45 degree, I think. Now after that, we'll just select this and go to object, path, divide object below, and this will divide this into smaller pieces. You can see that. In the same way, select this, go to object, path, divide object below, and after that, we'll select everything and just rotate it to its earlier position like this. So we got that. Now select everything, make sure the fill color is plain, like we'll select from here like light, and the stroke color black, so that we can see the color. So we have given all the shapes which we need. You can see we have given that cuts. Now next thing is, we'll fill it up with the color. So select this piece with the eye picker, eye, and with the shift and alt press just select this color. In the same way, select this with the eye picker, shift alt press, select this color, G, V for selection, select this with the eye picker, select this color. Firstly, we'll be selecting all the colors, then we'll do the gradient adjustment later. So I'll be selecting this, eye picker, select the color, V, select this, center one. For center one, we are given this. radial gradient. Now after that, select this with the eye picker, select this color. In the same way, I'll do the opposite one too with the selection tool. Select this with the eye picker, this one. So with the selection tool, select this with the eye picker, select the color from here with the shift and alt pressed. Now select this piece and select the color. We're left with these three pieces. So select this piece with the eye picker, select the blue color. Select this piece, eye picker, select the color, or maybe this, and select this with a V, I for eye picker, and with the shift and alt press, select this color. Now the next thing is we'll do the adjustment. We have got all the colors we need. We have already prepared our color palette and we have just applied it in a proper area. And the next thing is select these pieces, G for gradient color, and we'll do little adjustment here. So we'll do just do the adjustment, like we need dark here, light here, so we do that. And the same way, select this G from here, light to dark, like that, so that we can see that cut here. You can see nice one. The same way from here again, do it okay, like that. So we given that. Now next thing, select this G from here, light to dark, and the same way select this color G. Let's see the pattern. Okay, light to dark, so select from here till here. The same way, select this G, and we'll do little adjustment here. We'll keep this here center, we'll increase the diameter like this and make sure it's properly placed. We'll increase it a little bit more and we'll do the placement proper. So we'll just select this and just move it here and there like that. So you can see that. And after that, just go in here and place this around here so that we can give that shade of color here. In the same way with the G, with the V for selection tool, select this with the G, adjust this color from light to dark like that. We need a lighter here and darker here. Let's see. Okay, no, that's the opposite. We'll lighter to dark in the same way. Now next thing we'll do for this also, we'll with the V selection, with the G for gradient and light to dark. So we'll select lighter to darker. Selection tool G, and for this also we'll do the adjustment like this. We'll increase the diameter so that it's curves maintained. So we'll just increase it. You can see the curve is maintained. That will give a little nice feel like that. And we'll just increase it and move it like that. And after that, go in here and do the play with the gradient colors like that. If you need to go lighter or darker, you can adjust it. Now after that, select this with a V and with a G and apply from lighter to darker. So we applied that. We are left with three pieces. Select this G from lighter to darker. In the same way, select this G from lighter to darker. Select this G from lighter to darker. Let's check it out. Okay, that's fine. We can just move this a little bit here. And after that, let's see. Okay, we have given all the color and I think we have completed filling up the gradient colors and everything. And if you need more adjustment, you can just go in and do the adjustment with the gradient colors. And let's do the final step. We'll add the text. So T for text, Oratech. Let's keep it normal. Remove the caps lock. Oratech, Oratech. And let's choose the font. The font which we're using is Sigeo UI. So I'll just select this, type out SEGOE, Sigeo. And let's select UI. Let's check. We have given light. Just scale this up around. Let's use the scroll and just scale this up around 55. Let's check. Okay. And after that, let's do the adjustment. We'll select this half and give it bold and rest. It's okay. Now change the color. So to change the color, I'll use this with the app because just change this color. And we'll do the little adjustment here for make it light. Okay, that's fine. Now place this in the proper place like that. We can just move this little bit aside. So just select it and place it in a proper way. Use the ruler tool to do it correctly. So we'll just use the ruler here so that I can see the exact distance. So we can use the ruler tool and place the text in a proper position. So just use the arrow tools and make sure it's in, placed in the center like that, giving an exact distance, and remove the rulers by selecting it and deleting it. And after that, let's check it out. Okay, that's looking good. So this is how we have created this logo from start to final. So I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up. And if you want more updates on designing, you can press the subscribe button. Thank you.